No one on earth has the same fingerprints. The probability of two individuals sharing the same fingerprints is 1 in 64 billion. Based on those odds, researchers have calculated that it would take more than a million years for two people with identical fingerprints to appear by chance in Scotland Yard's fingerprint database. But if identical twins share almost exactly the same DNA, why aren't their fingerprints identical? While identical twins share many physical characteristics, each person has their own unique fingerprint. So before I answer why identical twins have different fingerprints, we need to first look at how fingerprints are formed. We need to rewind the clock to when you were a fetus in your mother's womb. Ever wondered when and how our fingerprints are formed? Fingerprints are essentially folds of the outer layer of your skin, the epidermis. Your fingerprints began to form when you were born. These patterns are created in the womb when you were barely 3 inches long. They were formed when you were between 13 and 19 weeks in your mother's womb. The skin has three main layers. The upper layer is called the epidermis, the middle layer is the basal layer, and the inner layer is the dermis. In a fetus, the sandwich basal layer grows faster than the other two layers of skin, and as a result, it kind of crumples in specific ways to produce the patterns on our fingertips that we call fingerprints. The precise details of the walls, arches, and loops are affected by many environmental factors from inside the womb. These factors are access to nutrition inside the womb, umbilical cord length, overall blood flow, blood pressure, position of the fetus inside the womb, the density of the amniotic fluid, and the overall rate of finger growth. As a result, identical twins may have similarities in the arches, holes, and loops in their fingerprints, but upon closer examination, you will notice differences in some of the smaller details, including spaces between ridges and divisions between branch markings. Due to environmental factors that affect their development inside the womb, it is impossible for identical twins to have the exact same fingerprints. Studies showed that fingerprints are stable over a person's lifetime. So your fingerprints are totally unique to you and have been since before you were born. No matter how much you change as you grow up, you will always have the set you have now, no matter how long you live. Now this leads to a very unique question. Why do we have fingerprints? Surprisingly, nobody really knows what fingerprints are for. They are not just useful for opening up one of the latest phones. People have long thought that fingerprints provide the friction that helps our hands grip objects. Other possibilities are that fingerprints improve your sense of touch or may help protect your fingers from injury, but scientists don't know for sure yet. Police have been using fingerprints and their unique loop, hole, and arch shapes to catch criminals for more than 2000 years, starting in ancient China. So there you go. Now you know why do we have fingerprints. Let me tell you an interesting fact. Fingerprints are not unique to humans. Chimpanzees and gorillas also have fine ridges on their fingertips that seem to be unique to individuals, which we probably inherited from a shared ancestor. Plus, a more distant relative, the koala, has independently evolved fingerprints that are surprisingly similar to ours. Amazing, isn't it? Can you now tell who the culprit is? Well, let the forensic department take the charge. And in the meantime, you can give this video a thumbs up. And while doing so, do check the patterns on your thumb and let me know in the comments below what patterns you see.